Welcome to Baldin's Fishery near Bridgnorth for another episode of Absolute Match Fishing. Today, I've got a real treat for you. I've got two of the country's best match fishing talents. First up is full England international Des Shipp. Now, those of you who know Des will realise he's probably won more matches than any other angler in the UK. However, he's got his work cut out today, as I've also brought along the mighty Andy Powers to fish against him. Andy won the first ever £50,000 match this final, and today both of them will be showing you their match winning tactics. Morning guys, how are we doing?
Matt, how are you mate?
Nice to see you both. Are you ready for it?
Yeah, of course
good,
we are.
Good. Well, first we're going to do the draw, and we're going to do it a little bit different to normal. I've got two wagglers in my hand, one's longer than the other, and whoever draws the longest float gets to pick a peg. So, who's going to go first?
Go on Andy. I know what's going to happen here anyway, so...
Well,
that took about a minute to get that out, so I obviously got the short and stumpy one, as per normal.
Cheers. So, Andy, you've got the pick of pegs, left or the right of the willow tree?
I think I'll go in the shade to the left of it.
Right.
Yeah, so I'm just going to get burnt in the sun and catch nothing.
Better get your sun cream out, mister. I'll come and rub some in for you.
I'll be back as well, Matt.
Well, maybe you might have to take off. Let's go get set up.
I chose this peg today. Begin with, at the moment it's in the shade, so hopefully it gives the fish a bit of shelter. Both the pegs are pretty much the same really.
Well, I've drawn to the right of the willow. Not quite sure what's going to happen. Obviously the willow's going to be a good shout today. It's very hot, so the fish are going to be to the shade. I've got a lovely sort of margin peg. I found sort of 18 inches of water, which I think's just about right for today. It's very deep, this lake's very deep. It's probably about 10 foot at 13 metres. And with the sun out, it's very warm. I don't think, personally, the fish are going to be on the bottom.
I've got a few tricks up my sleeve. I think there'll be quite a bit of shallow fishing today with it being so warm. And I can see a few ghost carp swimming around, so I might be able to mug a few. And then I'm going to fish down the edge with worms and casters, and hopefully that should do the goods.
I'm going to be fishing long, shallow, probably 11.5 metres with pellets or casters, depending on how the fish sort of react really. Definitely fish a top four. It's actually about 6 foot at top four. I've not made my mind up quite yet whether I'm going to fish top four or top five. I've never been here before, so not too sure. And then I'm just going to feed, some bait out of my hand, hit top four down the edge. And then my main line is going to be with dead maggots and micro pellets at about 10 metres. That's going to be my main attack. And by the willow, it's very rooty. There's lots of roots going out by the willow tree, and I think I'm just going away from the roots, and I'm going to fish shallow there as well, like I said, with casters and pellets. Just depends whether the little fish feed or not. If I get ragged out with little fish, then I'll be feeding hard pellet.
Des is definitely going to be a worthy opponent today. He's probably the best angler in the country. Everyone knows who he is. Everyone knows how good he is. He's just going to be awesome. I've definitely got my work cut out today.
Andy, you know, Andy's a fantastic angler. He's actually in a team that I was actually in many years ago before I joined the team I'm with now. And fair play to him, he travels all over the country, he enters all the big competitions, he's a team angler as well. So it's going to be very, very hard to beat him today. And he's obviously won the draw, so he's on the peg that he wanted, so we'll see. I'll give it the best shot.
Just marked the depth on my top kit. During the day I might catch a few fish and I might knock the float out of the place. By marking it I can use it as a reference point and put it back to the same depth every time, and I know it's going to be exactly the same.
We're just a few seconds before the start of the match now. Both anglers look pretty much ready to go. And I'm sure we'll see plenty of fish caught, and with some different baits, as they're both going to be using a lot of maggots, casters, and things you wouldn't normally associate with commercial fisheries. I make it just about time. All in!
Well, I'm going to go really careful with this one for the camera. It's an absolute beautiful common carp. You just lift him out and go really careful. Andy, if you want to just look through the tree, well, I think this could be the winner. So I think it's going to be a tough day. So fish like this is going to make a big, big difference. Let's get him back.
What sort of baits have you chose to fish down this edge here, Dan?
Well, obviously, Matt, because of the bait limits on, you know, any fishery really, I've decided to fish maybe casters down the edge.
Yeah.
And save the. I've got some dead maggots, got some casters, and I think with the fish being this time of year, it's very still, real hot. I think that's going to be the baits, to be honest. And I can chuck some casters right on top of me float, literally, you know, 10 casters right where I'm fishing. And I'm not, you know, I know that I've caught quality fish. If I was getting that, you know, tiny little rod and roach, I might have to change.
There is a lot of silver fish in commercials nowadays, isn't
there? And, you know, I sort of just started on this and then sort of see how it's going to go, really. And up to now, it's been good, you know. So I'm not going to change at the moment. I'm still feeding the other lines.
Yeah.
I've got a line short where I'm feeding pellet and corn. So I'm not going to waste my casters on that line at the moment. Do you know what I mean?
You're just sticking to this one
swim. I'm just sticking with that swim. I'm feeding a line to me right with dead maggot and micro pellet because you're not allowed to use ground bait on this venue. So the micro pellet to me is like my ground bait, if you like.
Yeah, lots of little particles
on
the bottom.
Yeah, and hopefully get the fish in me peg confident and see how we go, basically.
So shallow fishing down the margins, that's something that we don't see every day and it's certainly working.
That's
working
right, well. Yeah. I think especially for F1s as well. You go to a lot of F1 venues. And you know what they're like, F1s, as soon as you start loose feeding, they want to come up in the water and
competing
for bait, and that's what it's all about. I just missed a bite then. Right, all I've got is a 12 hollow. That's 015 mainline. Let's get you a look at me overalls. And I've got a 6-inch hook length of 013, 16 hook, obviously barbless because of the rules of the fishery, and I've just got four number 9 stocks bulk below the float.
And that's at about 10 or 12 inches.
About 10 inches, I would say that. Well, 12 inches probably, isn't it?
Lovely. You cannot get a rig.
You can't get no simpler than that. Nothing can go wrong. You know, it's a really strong, dumpy little float because I'm only fishing, so I don't want a long float.
Yeah.
I mean, that float is that long.
3 inches long.
Yeah, at most 3 inches.
Obviously, the fish can't bump into it and spook away.
No, and, you know, it can't get no simpler than that, really. And I can adjust, obviously, I've got a little bit of line from my elastic to me float, where if I want to go deeper, I can.
Right.
And I'm just going to keep feeding, Matt, while I'm talking to you.
You're a bit competitive
today. I am very competitive. You know me. I hate losing. And
all you're doing there is hooking the little head of the worm. And
just picking a piece of worm out, straight through the head like that. Probably just below it, like just before the saddle, you know. So there's a nice chunk, inch long. And you think, why does the carp pick a bit up like that?
It looks just like the casters you're feeding.
But it's about time of year, Matt, as well. You know, certain times of the year you can get away with this. Other times of year, you'll be fishing luncheon meat, sweet corn, hard pellets. It just depends on the little fish, really.
So if you can get away with fishing natural baits, you tend to.
I always take them. Obviously, it depends on fishery rules and your bait limits. You've got to take everything into account, you know. And it's all gambles, you know. Fishing can bite you in the bottom sometimes, can't it? You take the wrong bait, but that's, you know, you learn. That's the thing.
Got to make that right decision, I suppose, on the day, haven't you?
And I've never fished here before when the weather's been warm. So I think bringing natural baits, to me, is a good start. You know, it gives me the confidence that I can. And if the carp don't feed, I can catch silvers. Ooh,
another bite then.
Incredible, isn't it? Incredible, yeah. The bites.
There's a lot of fish there, Des.
And the thing is, you know, every bite you get is a quality fish. It's not a rudd, it's not a roach, it's a carp or an F1.
Well, I don't think you've had any silverfish so far, have you?
No, amazing. And hopefully we'll keep catching.
Hang on a minute, you told me you weren't catching and you've got one on now. Have you caught that one, Andy?
I've just gone in short with chopworm and caster on the deck, about 4 metres out.
Yeah.
It's not frantic, to be fair. I'm getting a lot of liners, so think I'm going to have to come shallow soon. But
that looks like an F1 as well.
Yeah, it's going all right at the moment. I'll stick with it for a bit.
What is interesting, Des is fishing shallow down the margins and he's catching mainly carp, and you've already said you've had quite a few F1s, haven't
you? Yeah, I haven't had many carp yet.
Still there, nice fish then.
Yeah. Chunky fish.
You're using worm on the hook as well?
Yeah, just a little piece of dendro there.
You could soon knock a weight up catching fish like that, couldn't you?
Yeah.
Especially such short distance.
Definitely, yeah. Good stamp of fish.
Yeah. Tell you what, before we shoot back out, let's might as well have a quick look at your rig now, haven't we?
Yep.
You could just talk us through it.
I've just got a size 16 hook.
Yeah.
6-inch hook length with a 013 line and two droppers and a bulk. Simple as that, really.
Doesn't get much simpler, does it? And that's set sort of 4 foot deep, maybe?
Yeah, probably just over. And I've got a 0.3 body float and 11 hollow, a little kinder pot to feed with.
Lovely stuff. Nice and simple. Get the bait down.
Yeah.
Right, let's get back out so you can catch us another one.
Chase the worm in. Just going to hook it through the head and nip a bit off.
I'll tell you what is a real eye-opener. Both of you are fishing with a worm on the hook, and so far I haven't seen either of you put any pellets in or any baits that you normally associate with commercial fishing.
I think worms and casters just catch you everything. They're going to guarantee you to get bites all year round, really.
Right. Have you fed any big amount of baits to start with, Andy, or have you just gone in with that small pot on the end of your pole?
I've started off with probably a quarter of a big pot of chopped worm and cast and a bit of corn, just to kick it off. And then after that, I've introduced like a small cad pot every put in.
Right, so you're just feeding enough to sort of attract one or two fish into your peg, hopefully catch them, and then do the same again next time.
Yeah, I've put a bit of corn in with it just to try and nail the feed to the deck. So I'm obviously getting quite a few liners, so I might have to come shallow out longer where I'm feeding casters.
So Andy, you've obviously paid a lot of attention to what you feed, because you've said you feed a different amount at the start and then change this once you're fishing and feed a little bit every time. So can you just show me sort of these amounts, because I think that's very important.
Yeah, basically because I've intended to start on that line, I haven't fed too much at the start because I want to go straight on it. So I just want that sort of initial response, really. I've probably just fed probably a quarter of the big pot.
Nice, sensible amount of bait.
I haven't got too many casters in there because obviously they're quite light and they're waft about a bit. I've got sort of corn and big chunks of worm to try and get a bait down.
Right, so it's these little things, like you've put a bit of corn in, and also you've said you don't chop your worms too finely.
Yeah, that's it.
Lovely stuff. And I'd be interested to see how much bait you feed every dropping, Andy. Can you give me a little demonstration?
I've got my cab pot on the end of the pole. I feed with that, and literally probably half a cab pot full. Squeeze it down. That way it goes down in one big lump, down to the bottom, and then hopefully we catch a fish.
Lovely stuff. Well, let's bait up and see if we can catch another one.
Okay.
Now then, Andy, what are you up to now? I can see that you've changed tactics and you've got one of your secret mugging rigs on there. This is a method that's won you some really big matches in the past, isn't it, Andy?
Yeah, it's we call it mugging. It basically involves a shallow rig, one with about 4x12, with a long length of line, sort of between 3 and 7 foot. And basically what I'm doing is I'm seeing a few carp cruising around, ghosties. I'm just swinging the rig in front of them and hoping they take it on the way past.
Mugging them?
Yeah.
I suppose that's where the term comes from, isn't it? But I mean, it's a dead exciting way of fishing. You can actually see the fish that you're fishing for and even pick the biggest one that's coming along, plop it in front of it, whack.
Yeah, it's definitely very exciting. And it usually picks up the bigger fish as well, because they're the ones that are cruising around.
one now, then, Les. I've changed, Matt.
Well, obviously, I was catching shallow by the tree, and they've sort of gone off, really, to be honest.
You were still catching really well as well.
Yeah,
there,
it's been good, and mostly carp as well, which is weird, because Andy, I think Andy's catching. I can't really see Andy, but... So what I've done, I've been priming my inside line up there. That's where I've been throwing most of my bait. I have primed the line up further as well with my big pot.
Right.
But what I've been doing there is throwing some dead maggots and also throwing the hard little ball of micros. Just stuck together. I can basically squeeze them like that. I've just thrown, it's only top four on my pole.
So you're just plopping it in.
Yeah, and like I said, when the fishing's good, you know, you don't really want to be going 11, 12 metres down the edge if they're there. Do you know what I mean? So what I do is feed both lines. So before I go on to me long line, I might not even have to go on it. It just depends how good this is. And I've dropped in, I've caught some lovely barbel.
Some whiskered friends.
Whiskered friends, they're beautiful. Up to, so 3 pound, Matt, absolutely beautiful.
Nice, and I suppose that's another advantage of fishing with things like maggots and casters is that you catch these fish as well.
Yeah, that's right, you catch everything. And the bites are incredible. It's actually a nasty shelf there. As you plumb up, it's all like that. It's like a sort of gravelly, real, quite a steep shelf, really. So what I've done, I've gone right in against the bank. It's probably 3 foot deep, straight down off the grass.
It's quite deep for a margin.
It is, really. That's probably why the barbel are coming in there, to be honest. And what I'm doing is just dropping me bait just out a little bit from where I'm feeding. So my up length and me bait is just sort of, I'm just holding it against the ledge, and the barbel are literally just dragging the elastic out.
Whack.
Oh, mass, under, you know, like that.
Wow. Ten minutes before the all out now, and I've been watching both these anglers all day. I wouldn't like to say what sort of weights they've got, but one thing I can promise you, there's going to be a hell of a lot of fish weighed in at the end of the session. This is it, folks, the end of the day. There's a few seconds left. Tick tock, I make that. All out!
Fish on.
It's been absolutely great. I've had millions of F1s, but Dez has definitely had some bigger fish. So I think he's edged it, I think.
Well, I've caught all day. I've had a fantastic day's fishing. I mean, frightening. F1, I've never caught so many ghost carp in my life. All sorts, common ghosties, mirror ghosties. I've gone down the edge, I've caught quite a lot of barbel. The carp have moved in down the edge now, so can't ask for better, really. I know Andy's got an absolute load of F1s, so I wouldn't want to call it. Just hope I've done enough, basically. And being on the last fish, now this could be all the difference.
So, Dez's first weigh. I'm going to say 48 pound exactly.
Thanks for that, Matt. For them barbel.
Now for the second way, for Dez. £34.9. Way number three. And that has registered the scales at £44.8. Another super weight. Brilliant. And the fourth way. £34, 15 ounces. Registered the scales at £49, 8 ounces. This is it, Des's final weigh in. I tell you what, Des, you must have some serious arm ache after today.
It is hurting a bit, Matt.
I bet. And, I'm going to give you £52 exactly for that one, which gives you, Des, a total weight of £262, 11 ounces.
Still don't think it's going to be enough, Matt.
Let's go and find out.
Yeah, let's go.
Okay. And his first weigh, £55, 10 ounces. Here we go. Another. Second weigh for Andy, another cracking net of fish. £44, 4 ounces. Oh. Day, £28, 1 ounce. Come on, Des, do the honours. This is Andy's final weigh.
£40 in there, Matt, I reckon, just over.
I'll tell you what, Des, you're not a bad guesser. I think that's more luck than judgement. I'm going to say £40 and 3 ounces. Well done, Andy.
Well done, Andy.
So that gives Andy £40, 3 ounces, a total weight of £168 and 2 ounces. Well done, mate.
Well done, Andy. Well fit.
Well done, mate.
That makes you the winner, sir.
Cheers.
Congratulations.
Cheers, mate. Really good day's fishing for both of you, though. Fantastic day.
Can't get the weather
has been brilliant, the fishing's been brilliant. What more can you ask for, really?
There you have it, folks. Another fantastic day on the bank with two of the UK's best match anglers. It took me nearly 20 years to catch my first £100, and both of these have made it look easy today. We'll catch you next time on Absolute Match Fishing.